Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha, and we are gonna talk about hair. I think hair is one of the most requested topic, like hair care, hair tips, something which has been like most requested on my channel ever. So I thought, why not do a video where like telling sharing my basic knowledge of hair. But these are hair tips which I thoroughly follow and which I think make a huge difference in the health of your hair. So yeah, I thought I'll share it to you guys. So let's get started. So I do have a lot of points about hair, but I'll just tell you randomly because I really don't know what order would make sense anyway. But before getting into that, I just want to say two things. One is hair genetics and one is your diet. So hair genetics is really, really, really like a key role on what your hair actually is. I think I have really good hair is like because of my mom. My mom has really good hair and her mom has really good hair. So hair is extremely genetic, guys. I mean, the how good your hair or how bad your hair is, basically in the good and bad, I mean the thickness and the volume. And a person can have like as much as hair I have, but they could have really smooth hair, like really thin and straight hair, so it would not look like as voluminous as my hair. So it really, really, all that is like definitely just genetics. You like we cannot really change it unless you get chemically treated or something like that. So don't always treasure yourself when you look at someone that they have really voluminous hair. It is mostly genetics, unless like you have some hair condition, like you have some hair issues. Mostly hair is genetics, and you could do a few things here and there, but don't stress so much about hair, you guys. Like the stress is something which actually makes your hair even worse. So just keep that in mind. And one more thing is diet. Like our hair is 90% protein, you guys, and the best way to make it grow or keep it healthy is to give your body protein as well. And protein is generally also really important for you in your like daily life, but for your hair, protein really does more wonderful things. So try to inculcate like eggs and meat if you're like in a non-vegetarian. If you're a vegetarian, then peanut butter or peanuts, basically, or dal. Like just search for really high protein foods and try to have that. It's really good for your hair, for your body. Protein is something which I think a lot of Indian people miss in their regular meals, because unless we have like non-veg or something, protein is something we have really, really less. So those the points that I generally wanted to touch on. Now let's move on to the main hair tips which help your hair's health and everything. So the first one being hot showers, guys. All of us love taking like good really long showers, but I told you hair is 90% protein, and something which would break down protein really easily is heat. Not only your styling, but your long hot like water showers also damage your hair really, really like a lot. And it's even said that a long exposure of your hair to water also causes a lot of damage, prolonged exposure to water. So you need to be very mindful, like use lukewarm water. I always use very, very lukewarm water. I never use hot water on my hair. It's not ideal. It'll generally, it's just gonna burn your hair, like not literally burn, but it is going to damage your hair a lot. The next point is oiling your hair. And I know, guys, see, I don't know why, especially to our kids, like not our kids, I mean we kids, this generation and like a teenage generation, I don't know why this thing has become that oiling your hair is not cool, or basically like oil is bad. I stop acting cool for everything. It's just for nourishing your hair, bro. Like let's talk about in general terms. You use a hair mask, you use it to the ends of your hair. You use a conditioner, you use it to the ends of your hair. You use a shampoo, you just cleanse your hair and it's gone. What exactly, like which product exactly is actually getting into your roots to help it strengthen your hair or help it grow faster? Nothing. Only thing which is going to help you do that is a hair oil. Hair oil is extremely important for your hair, and you might find it gross, but if you want really good hair, then you have to use it. Few people generally have good hair, so good for them. If they don't want to use, they cannot use. But hair oil is really, really important, you guys. Hair oil is something a lot of our ancestors have used, and that's the reason they had really amazing hair. Even like at 60s, they had really good hair. And we people at 20s are suffering with hair fall, whatnot, like so many different things. Hair oil is extremely important to have for hair nourishment. Hair oil is that one universal thing which help in hair growth, strengthening of the roots, nourishing of the hair, everything. Oiling your hair is really, really important. If you don't oil your hair and you complain about it being, you know, dry, it being like, it's going like falling off, it's not growing, then I mean, your complaints don't seem valid to me at that time, because you're just like not giving your hair what it needs. So I just wanted to show you guys one oil which I've been thoroughly enjoying these days and which I use a lot. So this is the Secret Hair Oil Black Charm. This would be a really, really good hair oil option for you, like if you're looking for a really good hair oil. So it has like beautiful ingredients. It has vetiver roots, it has marshmallow, amla and coconut oil. So basically I just, you know, break down what they actually do to your hair. So vetiver is not only good for hair, vetiver is, you know, seen in a lot of skincare products as well, because it's extremely anti-inflammatory and antimicrobial. So basically what it does for your hair, it fights dandruff, it helps in a lot of blood circulation. So vetiver roots is really, really good for your, you know, skin and hair, and I rarely find vetiver roots in a hair product, and I was really surprised to find it in this, because it is a really, really good product. And it has marshmallow roots, it has amla. Amla, I think I don't have to describe amla. Amla is known for the best ingredient for hair. It has like, I mean, I can put down an entire list of benefits it has. It has so many good properties. It again helps in amla is sometimes even known to, you know, maintain the pigmentation of your hair. So even if you have hair color, even if you have like told to reduce the grayness of your hair, those are, you know, few things which I said, but amla is generally really good for your hair. It's good for hair growth, it is good for nourishment, it is good for dandruff, it's good for so many different things, guys. Like, amla is one of the best things for hair. And again, the our good old coconut oil, I don't think again I have to explain, really, really good ingredient to have for your hair. It's extremely nourishing on the hair, helps in hair growth, helps in, you know, re-strengthening your hair roots as well. So coconut oil is something which is actually there, not like lot of oils, but usually what happens is when there's one coconut oil, then you have to mix 100 different things to actually make it a good oil. So that's one thing I like about this oil, that they have really good, like, you know, concoction of products in this. And you can see, like, you know, I don't know, there's a lot of product here, so you can like kind of mix before using it so that all that thing gets mixed up. So this is a really amazing oil. If you do want to check this out, you can, I'll put it in the description. And actually when I checked their Instagram, I mean, the results of the hair, like a lot of people, they post before and after, so you can definitely check their Instagram as well if you want to know more about that oil. So again, there's a way to apply oil as well, and make sure you partition really well. I just insert a small clip here of my mom applying my oil. She like properly takes all the divisions, applies it really well. You can even warm your oil and use it. Actually helps it to get into the roots really well as well. That is a really good thing to do, and I always do heat up my oil before applying it to the hair. So yeah, oiling your hair is really important. I think I spoke a lot about oil because I get really irritated when I see tell somebody about oil, or like they see oil, they go, I'm like, you are you. So next point is again a very basic point which a lot of people talk about, is overwashing your hair. I know a lot of people think that they need to wash their hair every single day because they see that, you know, there's oil creeping through the scalp. But let's talk in terms of skin, you guys. Like, I tell a lot of times that you don't have to overwash your face. Like, you know, a lot of people overwash their face, and that's the reason their face is actually more oily. What our skin basically does is, if you strip it off from its essential oils, it tends to produce more oil to compensate the dryness which you have created. So you need to be mindful that your scalp is skin too, and that is what happens if you overwash your hair as well. So a lot of people wash every single day because they got their hair habituated to that. So like every single day they're stripping it off from its essential oils, and every day it's like producing too much oil, and by the next day they do have like extremely oily hair. So it is, you know, definitely difficult to cut it down when your hair is like really habituated to wash every single day. But listen to me, like, I personally wash my hair minimum gap of 3 days. I wash my hair every 3 days, if not 4 days. I can push it as long as I want, but maybe 4 days is like, you know, very ideal to wash your hair. But every every single day is not advisable. So for somebody who's used to, you know, washing your hair every single day, you can start like implementing it every like alternate days. Try doing it every alternate day, and then you can increase to every second day, like, you know, this every 2 days. See, this thing, you need to get your hair like habituated to it, because you've been stripping so much oil, it's like producing, so it's like a, you know, habit which your skin has. So you need to get used to, like, you know, washing it less and giving your hair time to, you know, get adjusted to the process, and, you know, letting it stay that, bro, you know, you could have your oils for some time. So don't wash your hair every single day. It doesn't do any good for your hair. And again, I told you, long exposure of hair to the water is also not so great for the hair. Next one is double cleansing your scalp. So I say double cleansing because I wash my hair once in 4 days. So I when I cleanse my face in the night, I double cleanse it because I want to get rid of all the, you know, what do you call that, gunk on my face. So double cleansing for scalp also helps. So like when you apply hair oil and then you want to get rid of the oil and the dirt and everything, so I apply my shampoo twice. So first time I just I lather it up, I washed off, and the second time I reapply. And I do use a lot of dry shampoo, this and that. So for me, it's really important, like, I get in there and properly, you know, cleanse everything off. So I do definitely double cleanse my scalp. The hair balding or hairline decrementing, whatever you call that, dude, I see so many people in buns every single day, like, you know, with lifted hair. It's even my sister does this. Every time I video call her, we have this conversation, she constantly keeps like pulling her hair backwards. She constantly has it, like, you know, combed it upwards. And I don't know if you guys remember this, I think everybody does, but we all were in that poof stage. If you're at 23 years, if you're my, you know, as old as I am. So back in school, I think in 9th standard or 10th standard, there was a very big poof stage. So everybody wanted to have that poof or puff or whatever you want to call that. So I also got into that trend, and I don't know if you can see that, but this side I have bald hair now. Like, I don't have that spot because I was constantly just combing my hair up, 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 up. And this, I think in 2 years into it, I realized that, you know, it is making me a little bald. And I, since then, you know, never do that. If I'm at home, I always, if you see my stories on Instagram, my hair is always laid down in a ponytail, like, you know, very loose ponytail, or it is open, or it's like very, very loose braid or something. I never ever just, you know, comb my hair upwards. I never do high ponytails, never do high buns. So see, high ponytails, high buns, if you're going out once in a while, it's fine, but on a daily basis, please don't do that. Doesn't do good for your hair. It's always like you're putting a lot of stress on the hair, and the, if, like, you know, the hair follicle can kind of like just prick off and come off. So don't put so much strength, and especially if you have somebody who has really weak roots or really weak hair strength, so it can, you know, cause a lot of hair fall, a lot of like line decrementing. So always make sure hair is loosely tied. And this is one thing I always do. I never do like tight hair ties, night anything. So, and for hair ties, I always use a scrunchie, guys. These are like the best thing ever. Stop using rubber bands. The time is gone, the period is gone. Please, please, please move on to scrunchies. There are a lot of benefits for scrunchies. First, it doesn't, like, you know, really like be tight on your hair. And even if you, like, you know, to apply two layer, like, you know, 2 to 3 rounds and tighten your hair, it doesn't leave that weird mark like what a rubber band does. When you're styling your hair, you know that, you know, sometimes you tighten a rubber band and you leave it, you kind of get that weird rubber band mark, and scrunchies help prevent that as well. Scrunchies have so many benefits, so always definitely go for a scrunchie. The rubber band period is gone, over. And one more thing is, if you want to clip your hair, stop using that tick-tick clips. It is not worth it, because you know, I don't know if it happens to anybody, but every time I use those tick-tick wale clips, whenever I remove, at least one strand of hair would, like, you know, come off with it. So upar ka that round mein, my hair used to get stuck, and like when I remove, my hair used to come off as well. So the best way to, you know, if you want to clip your hair back, then buy these hair pins. So you can just like normally put it there and it'll hold your hair, which is really nice, because it's not doing, like, it's, first of all, it's not putting any stress. Second of all, it's like really easy to remove. There's no nothing holding onto it or anything. And third of all, if you have like your hair set. These, like, you know, lay down your hair really well as well. So even if you wet your hair while washing your hair, they kind of dry down this way, so you don't have to reset it sometimes. So these have really good benefits, so try to give like options to your hair. Don't always stress your hair so much. Next point is sun damage. Yes, like your skin gets damaged with sun, your hair is also going to get extremely damaged by sun. So whenever you're going out, make sure you're covering your hair, like at least tie it in like normal bun, and wear a scarf or wear a hat. Don't like expose your hair for long hours in the sun. It is going to damage your hair. Avoid as much as sun generally also, like for hair, skin, it's good for everything. Avoid sun. Next is, do not rub your hair against the towel. So many people take the hair and keep rubbing it to dry it. Don't do it, guys. Don't do it. If you just want, take a hair and just scrunch your hair, like if you want that the water to go away, don't rub your hair. Not going to do anything. It's just going to make your hair really more frizzy. Next point is hard water and soft water, guys. I'm telling you this point with my personal experience. Back in 11th and 12th, I was in a hostel, and that hostel had really hard water. By hard water, I mean extremely salt water. My hair was in the worst condition back then. I had extreme hair fall, extreme like dry, like really dry hair because of the water. So it could, like, some a few people, it might affect. The really hard water is not good for your hair. So the area you're living in could be a reason for why your hair is like that as well. If you could maybe invest in a water softener, or maybe soften your water with some thing which makes it more alkaline, like apple cider vinegar or something like that. So just check if your water is really hard. That is the reason which might make your hair really bad as well, because I had that 2 years. My hair was the worst ever. The next point is treating your scalp and your, like, you know, ends differently. Scalp is something you need to pay a lot more attention than this. This, whatever you do here, is only going to help in nourishing your hair and keeping it that silky, nice and, like, you know, straight and not frizzy. But your scalp is what is going to make your hair healthy in terms of thickness, in terms of growth, in terms of strengthening the roots and all that. So whatever you're doing, like a treatment, is more importantly to be done on the, like, you know, hair scalp. So let it say you're using an oil, let it say you're doing like a spa treatment to get that oil, whatever it is, concentrate more on the scalp, yes, on the scalp if you want to, you know, improve the health of your hair. A lot of people say that split ends stop in hair growth. While that is true to some extent, split ends don't do anything regarding the hair growth. What happens ideally is, like, your hair keeps growing, but if you have split ends, your hair is going to, like, split, and you're not going to see that growth. And if you have split ends always on your hair, it's going to move towards the roots a lot quicker, which again diminishes the health of your hair. So it's always ideal to trim your hair, if not 3 months, at least 6 months, once every 3 to 6 months, trim your hair a little bit, get rid of that split ends. Your hair is going to look a lot better, it's going to feel a lot better. Next point is hair coloring. I personally never colored my hair, maybe once, like I did some stupid streaks and I hated it back then. So, but this was like years and years ago, and after that, I don't know. I know that hair color is bad, so I never really took that step towards hair color. And if you do go for hair color, then you be very responsible. It is a full-time job after that, because you have to take care of your hair really well. So basically all these colors, whatever they deposit on your hair, break the bonds of your original hair so that the color is properly deposited on the hair. So you need to be mindful, and especially avoid bleaching as much as you can, and we go for like some browns or something. But if you do go for bleach, then make sure you go to somebody who really knows hair, who can really like help your hair even after bleaching it, so that it doesn't look like one rusty, musty like hair. So bleaching is something I would never, I'm saying this, I'm putting it out there, I would never ever bleach my hair. I don't think it's for me. So maybe hair color sometime, I don't know, I don't see me doing it in the future, like in the near future anyway. Sometimes if I genuinely want to try, then I might try it. But avoid hair color if you really want extremely healthy hair. And one more is stop using these this is for actually for people who do, like, you know, get a lot of gray. So those people tend to color the hair and the roots, especially every month or every 20 days, and a lot of people use a lot of cheap based color the hair. Stop using all these like 5-minute hair color, 10-minute hair color. These are the worst hair colors you could ever use. Like, hair coloring on a general level might affect your hair, but these affect your hair the most. Like, at least if you're going to go with some like colors beneath, you're still, you know, coloring the ends of your hair, you're not like coloring the scalp. But if you're, you know, somebody who colors your grays a lot, you kind of, you know, obviously color the roots. I'm talking too much. So those things, don't, please stay away with those 20 rupee hair color, that 5-minute hair color. Those things have a lot of ammonia, like lot of ammonia, and ammonia is the worst thing for your hair strength, like health. It breaks down and it makes your hair less and less healthier, and when you apply it really frequently, it like ruins the strength of your hair. It doesn't, like, it stops hair growth, it does a lot of different things. You can see this is something I heard. This is not, I don't know so much about hair, but these are few things I know because I've read some things, seen some things. So mainly avoid these stupid hair colors which are in the market for 20 rupees for 5 minutes. No good is coming out of it. Please stay out like of these hair. I think once my mom used it, I got supremely angry, and she, even after that, something happened, you know, because of the hair color, she started getting some weird like irritation around the, you know, eye area. So that also can always be a huge difference, like, you know, huge impact of a really bad hair color. Next is, do not comb your hair when it is wet, you guys. Please do not comb your hair when it's wet, especially when you come out of the shower. Please don't comb your hair. It's extremely sensitive. Your hair is extremely sensitive when it is wet. So if you comb your hair during it's wet, it's going to cause a lot of hair fall. That gets me to the other point, that don't blow dry your hair when it's wet as well. So I blow dry my hair when it's like 80-90% wet, because like if I'm going to run my comb and blow dry my hair properly, blow dry set my hair, I'm not talking about blow drying, like drying the hair, I'm talking about blow drying setting the hair. I'm going to run my comb and set my hair, like when it is wet, I'm going to like be bald in like 2 months, like if I'm going to do wet hair drying or styling every time. But again, blow drying gets me to another point, which is, don't blow dry your hair if you have really weak hair. Like if you're somebody who's suffering with hair fall, please don't blow dry yours. Like I all frequently say, like when somebody asks me, how do you have, like, you know, that proper set hair, every time I do tell that I blow dry set my hair. But if you're somebody who has hair fall issue, then you might want to stay away from blow dry, because blow dry is literally like tugging on your hair and blow drying it. So when you pull and put that stress, your hair might fall off a lot. So like avoid blow drying if you are somebody who has hair fall. So one last thing is, I know a lot of people don't comb their hair. It's extremely essential to comb your hair. See, a lot of curly hair people, don't come for me, I'm not asking you to comb your hair, don't comb your hair. I understand the curls do disappear once you comb your hair, but at least comb your hair right before you go for your hair wash, so that, you know, there's no tangle, and when you're washing, you don't like end up having like a lot of knots, and then like by detangling those knots, you kind of end up losing a lot of hair. So always ensure you comb your hair before going to the shower, and always ensure you have a really good hair comb. Don't buy some random comb which is for 5 rupees, 10 rupees, because usually what happens is the ends are really sharp, and sometimes if you comb your scalp with it, it kind of hurts your scalp. So go with combs which are more rounded or tipped off, so that it's a lot gentler on the hair, and go with something which is wide tools to detangle your hair. Don't go with something which is extremely thin. These are really small points, but these are really important points, you guys. So I think that is the last point. These are the points which came up out of mine, which I regularly follow. There might be some other things which I have, maybe I'll make a future video about it. So but I hope these points were helpful, and if you like the video, then make sure you like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.